Welcome to another report in the oil market. Oil prices came tumbling down in the past days, making the case for the steepest fall on a weekly basis since a considerable time back. The major price action in the first days of August seems promising for traders, and this report aims at reviewing the current fundamentals that can help traders understand the most recent price movement. We will also be looking into some oil market metrics, while our technical analysis at the end will assist us with identifying the most important trends and levels for WTI. Starting first with the matter that seems to capture most of the attention in the media at the moment, which is the spread of the Delta variant around the world. Oil traders are constantly monitoring the updates of the subject, trying to examine its impact on the markets. Countries like the US and China, the two largest economies of the world, have seen a dramatic increase in cases, which is currently sending the message that a fourth wave is on the rise. Yet, from the oil traders' perspective, the major concern is the potential impact on the fundamental strengths of the oil sector, which is supply and demand. Reuters stated that China and Japan imposed restrictions in some cities and cancelled flights, which could be the first signs of reduced demand. The news is considerably demotivating for the oil buyers, especially in the case of China, which is considered among the biggest oil-consuming countries and is now probably reducing the use of fuel as a response. Moreover, in search for more information on supply and demand, we move now to the weekly oil market metrics. Monitoring what happened in the past week, we make a start with the Baker Hughes oil rig count weekly reading, which pointed out that active oil rigs had dropped to 385 from previous 387. This is the first drop in active oil rigs since the previous June, and the reading could have prepared the road for what could follow in the current week. On Tuesday, the American Petroleum Institute indicated a minor drawdown of minus 0.88 million barrels, while the Energy Information Administration's crude oil inventories released on Wednesday indicated a considerable surplus of plus 3.63 million barrels. Both the readings tend to support the notion of a more bearish market for the commodity, while combined with the fears and reaction towards the Delta variant, the effect may have been enhanced. Overall, and rather contradicting to our previous matter, global oil supply seems constrained despite the decision by the Organization of the Petroleum Exporting Countries and their allies to raise production in the following months until the end of the current year. However, comments made by Russian Deputy Prime Minister Alexander Novak in the past week, stating oil demand continues to be on the rise, can also make sense at this point. Oil traders should consider how emotional the oil industry is to updates on the pandemic and way information coming in. From our point of view, the Chinese, US and European economies may be doing better than initially thought, even though much more progress is required. Is this a sign of support for the oil market? Yet the fact is that people could be getting used to the measures imposed could also benefit oil prices. Moving now to the technical analysis in WTI's 4-hour chart, at the moment the commodity's price is characterized by a steep downward movement highlighted by the channel formed with black lines. As noted, the trend has started on the 2nd of August and has made consecutive stops lower, emphasizing our R3 71.40, then the R2 70.10, and very recently the R1 68.60. If the trend is to reverse, then the possible levels upwards could be the pre-mentioned in a reversed manner. On the contrary, and if the commodity is to continue to fall, we would expect the S1 66.60 support to be tested first, while the S2 64.95 hurdle that was tested briefly on the 20th of July can also become a target. However, the S3 63.5 remains our lowest level for this 4-hour chart. The RSI indicator below our chart seems to have stabilized nearby 30, confirming the oversold tone among traders. Yet the scenario of a reverse is also in play, with contrarian volatility possibly attempting to regain some ground lost. Overall, the most important levels, in our opinion, are the S1 66.60 that was tested various times in the past months, while the R1 68.60 and the R2 70.10 can also be enticing in a more sideways movement scenario. That's the end of this report. We hope you enjoyed it as well as found it useful. If you like this video, please feel free to share and subscribe. Also, as an effort to further support traders with valuable information, We are now carrying out weekly webinars on trending subjects, and all our subscribers are welcome to participate. Thank you very much for your time. From everyone here at IronFX, best wishes for solid trading.